treasure, all the things we hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you.
Thank you.
know Roxie was no anymore. Is that right?
That's right, officer.
Why aren't you the cheerful little murderer?
Murderer? Why just last week the jury thanked the man for shooting a burglar?
Well, that's all. Sign on here, Mr. Hart.
Freely and gladly. Freely and gladly. For her first number, Miss Roxie Hart would like to sing a song of love and devotion, dedicated to her dear husband, Angus.
Sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong, but he doesn't care. He'll string along. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine. Sometimes I'm down, sometimes I'm up, but he follows round. their arsenic. He had it from Roxie. He had it from Roxie. He took a flower, Roxie, and then he used it. And he abused it.
Because the novels and character. I talked to Flynn. He said it's a trial date for March the 5th. March 7th, you'll be acquitted. And March 8th, you know what Mama's gonna do for you? She's gonna start you on a vaudeville tour.
I've been on a lot of vaudeville tours, Mama. What kind of tour are we talking?
Well, I've been talking to the boys at Wilma Morris, and due to your recent sensational activities, I could get you $2,500.
$2,500? Must be a Veronica at her age 350.
Well, before Cicero, before Billy Flynn, and before Mama.
Mama, I always wanted to play Big Jim's Colossima. Do you think you could get that for me?
Big Jim's? That's another story. That might take another phone call.
How much is that phone call going to cost?
You know how I feel about you. You're like family. I'll do it for $50.
$50 for a phone call? You must have a lot of long numbers, Mom.
If you want my gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for Mama.
$5,000?
I have to make that phone call for you, dearie. $5,000? Now am I going to get $5,000?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's happened.
Oh, Amos, I knew you'd come. I've been sinful, but I want to make it up to you. And I will too, as soon as I get here. You see, there's this lawyer and he costs about $5,000.
Roxie, I am tired of your fancy footwork. The answer is no!
Look, I don't have an idea. I don't want to cheat on you. I've even stolen money from your pantbox before you were sleeping.
Wait,
you did? But I never stopped loving you! Not my Amos. So handsome, so attractive, so embarrassed, so sexy.
Roxie, $5,000!
It's my hour of need!
Fine, Roxie. I'll get it for you. I'll get it. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the Silver Tongue Prince of the courtroom, the one, the only, Mr. Billy Flynn! Yes.
Right. Did you bring the rest of my $5,000?
Yeah. Here's $200 on the building and loan fund, and another $300 from the guys at the garage, and another $500 from the insurance.
That's $2,000.
That's all I got so far.
What about her father?
Her father, I phoned him yesterday, and he told me he'll probably be able to raise some money later.
You're a liar. I spoke to her father myself. You know what he told me? That his daughter went to hell 10 years ago, and she could stay there forever before he'd spend a cent to get her out.
Look, Mr. Flynn, I'll give you $20 a week on my salary. I'll give you notes with interest, and double, triple, until every cent is paid.
You know, that's touching, but I've got a motto. And that motto is, play square. Dead square. Now, when you came to me the other day, I didn't ask you if she was guilty. I didn't ask you if she was innocent. No foolish questions like that, now, did I? All I asked you was, have you got $5,000? And you said, but you haven't got $5,000. So I figured you're a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I took her case, and I'll keep it, because I play square. Now, here's what we're going to do. By tomorrow morning, I'll have her on every front page as a hot set of jazz players in Velma Kelly. Then, we'll an auction to raise money for her defense. But why anything she's ever touched? Shoes, dresses, underwear? Plus, we'll tell them that if I do cross the line, she does get hanged.
Wait, hanged?
The stuff triples in value, and I'll give you 20% of everything you make over $5,000. Because that's what I call plain swear.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
You see, it's like this. Either I get the entire $5,000, or you'll rot in jail before I really try. Now, in a couple moments here, we're going to have a big press conference. There'll be a whole bunch of photographers and reporters. That's soft sister from the Evening Star is coming. Merry Sunshine.
Mary Sunshine's gonna interview me? Holy shit.
Hey, put it down to swearing. From here, I didn't say nothing rougher than, oh dear, get it? The first thing we have to do is go off the sympathy from the press. But I'm all pushovers like that Mary Sunshine. Chicago's a tough town. It's gotten so tough, they'll shoot the girl right from under you. Well, there's one thing that they can never resist, and that's a reformed sin. So I decided to rewrite the story of your life. From convents to jail. Get this. Beautiful summer home. Every luxury and refinement. Parents dead. Educated at the Sacred Heart. Fortune swept away. A runaway marriage. A lovely, innocent girl bewildered by what's happened to her. Young, full of life. Lonely. You're caught by the mad world of great city, with jazz, cabarets, and liquor. Sit down. You're drawn like a monster flame, and now the mad world has ceased. A butterfly crushed under a wheel. You've sinned, and you are sorry.
That's
cute. Now, when they ask you why you killed him, all you can remember is a fearful quarrel, and he threatened to kill you. You can still see him coming towards you with that awful look in his eyes. And get this. You both reach for the gun. That's your grounds. Self-defense.
Let him
in, OJ. Well, good day, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Sunshine. You want to know my client, Miss Roxie?
Ladies and gentlemen, well, I'm so glad you're not here to see little old me. I guess you want to know why I shot the rats.
Sit down, dummy.
Mr. Billy Flynn sings the press conference rap. Notice how his mouth never moves. Almost.
Mississippi.
Thank you.
Now I got me a world full of yes.
The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxie. The lady raking in the chips is gonna be Roxie. I'm gonna be a celebrity that means somebody everyone knows. They gonna recognize my eyes, my hair, my teeth, my boobs, my mouth. From just some sunlight mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Roxie. Who says that murder's not?
Today is that heart kid.
Say, idea. Suppose I talk Hart into doing the sister act with me.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Velma Kelly, in an act of desperation.
My sister and I had an act that couldn't flop. My sister and I were headed straight for the top. My sister and I are in the vow of being at least out. But my sister is now unfortunately deceased. Oh, I know it's sad, of course, but a fact is still a fact. And now all that remains is the remains of a perfect double act. Roxie, do you know that you're exactly the same size as my sister? I mean, you fit into her wardrobe perfectly. Say, why don't I just show you somebody act? Watch this.
Oh.
See? Or would I tell you?
Why, Sid! Make sure to drive faster!
You're filling Velma! You're a man of death!
Gentlemen, please, my client will be happy to answer all your questions. Ow! Will you stop biting me? I'll get hydrophobia.
Oh, good, Al! I'm not answering any more of your questions.
Come on, Gary. I'm gonna show you through the feet. You're gonna love it.
But wait! Do you even know who my father is?
Who?
Well, he's a whole white. Chocolate! And go to hell! And you can't! And you can't! All you can!
Step right in here. My client will answer all your questions, and afterward, I'll be happy to give you an interview myself. Hi, Trixie.
Trixie?
I mean Roxie. Boy, what the hell are you? And a socialite, too. Her mother owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
What do I care about pineapples? Do you have a child with
it? Take it easy, kid. I'll get to it.
Hey, Billy. I want to talk to you about my child, Dave, also.
Hi, Velma. First things first. Oh, man, this sunshine. I thought you married the girl for your pineapple money. It's a gripping story, really.
Ugh. Pineapples. I got a feeling you're in trouble, Roxie.
Socialite. You lose again, Velma.
There's only one person who can help you now, Roxie.
There's only one person you can count on now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxie Hart, Miss Velma Kelly, in a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
Thank you. Everyone gets known.
it should be. Invisible, inconsequential.
Thank you.
do that again. Alright, I got Amos to file for divorce.
Yeah? So now what?
So now, I can get him on the stand and get him to admit that he made this terrible mistake because he still loves you. Of course, you still love him. And now the jury will be falling over themselves to play Cupid and get you two back together. Smart, huh?
Smart, man.
And another thing.
Hey, nothing.
When Amos is on the stand, I want you to be knitting a baby on him.
Knitting? I don't know how to knit.
They'll learn.
Look, I'm tired of everybody treating me like I'm some dumb common criminal.
Oh, I'm so sorry, sweetie. But you are some dumb common criminal.
Instead of being a greasy lawyer who's out for all he can steal.
Oh, I bet you could appear in court without me too, huh?
Maybe I could. Just read more than Amos, Housie. They love me.
Listen, kid. You're a phony celebrity. In a couple of weeks, nobody will even know who you are. That's Chicago. So now we're clear on what you're doing on the stand?
I have enough rehearsal all night.
You ready?
I'm scared.
You got nothing to worry about. It's all a circus, kid. A three-ring circus. These trials, the whole world, it's all show business. But kid, you're working with a star. The biggest.
Give on the old razzle dazzle, on. Give up an act with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give up the old hocus pocus, reed and feather on it. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if the hinges all are rusty? What if in fact you're just disgusting. Razzle dazzle, and they'll never get wise.
Thank you.
gentlemen, we present justice.
The state of Illinois versus Roxie Hart for the murder of Fred Paisley. Thank you.
The state calls Mr. Amos Hart. Question by Sergeant Fogarty. What happened next? Answered by Miss Roxie Hart. I shot him because he walked out on me. The laughs. Signed, Miss Roxie Hart. Now tell me, do you recognize that signature?
Yes, that's the signature of a woman who used to be my wife.
Exactly. Take the witness.
Well, hello, Amos.
Amos! My name is... Wait,
Amos. Amos, you are present obtaining a divorce from my client. Is there any reason for this?
I'll say. The newspaper said that she was expecting a little stranger.
Well, that's hardly grounds for divorce, is it?
A little too much of a stranger.
Oh, by that you mean you doubted the paternity of the child.
Well, sure.
Did you ever take the chance to, well, ask Roxie if you were the father? You just jump to a conclusion like that? You call that plain and square? If Roxie swore to you right now that you were the father of her child, which she does.
What?
I do.
She does! Step down, Daddy. The defense calls Roxie Hart. Statement in which you've admitted to having an illicit relationship with the deceased Fred Paisley. Is this true or false?
I'm afraid that's true.
But you are married, Miss Hart.
I know. And I don't think I would have gone with him if Mr. Hart and I had a quarrel that very morning.
Quarrel? About what?
Oh, Amos. I don't like working at that cheap Southside nightclub.
Yeah.
I don't like working those long hours at the garage either.
Sure.
Amos, I want a real home. And a child.
A child? Seriously, Roxie? Factions!
So you drifted into this illicit relationship with Casey because you are unhappy at home?
Most unhappy.
But you do respect the sacredness of the married vow, don't you?
Oh, yes, sir.
Then why didn't you stop this affair with Casey?
Well, I tried to, but Mr. Casey, he pleaded. He'd say,
I can't live without you! I can't live without you! I can't live without you!
Roxie Hart, the state of Illinois accuses you of the murder of Fred Casely. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty? Yes, I killed him. But I'm not a murderer.
Roxie, can you recall the night of February 14th?
Yes, sir.
Tell the jury in your own way what happened that night.
Well, it was around 2 a.m. and I stopped at online grocery to pick up some baking powder to make cupcakes for my Amos. Oh, Amos, he just loved my cupcakes. And I went back home and I started getting ready for bed when suddenly the doorbell rang. Now, I thought it was my girlfriend, Gloria, so I slipped on my kimono and I went to the door.
And who was there?
Fred Casely.
What did he say, Roxie?
That letter you wrote me! Tell me it was all over! Why'd you write it? Because I've seen the error of my ways.
What did you say, Roxie?
I said, go away!
Beat it, buddy!
Sit down!
I tried to close the door, but he forced his way in. I ran to the bedroom, but he followed me. Please, no good will come of this. And besides, I love my husband.
So you told him you loved your husband. What did he say to that?
It doesn't matter! You're mine! You're mine! You're mine! I can't believe it.
You must tell the jury everything. They have the right to know.
I are going to have a baby.
And what did he say to that?
I'll kill you before I steal another man's child!
What happened next?
It
Maurine.
And then?
And then we both reached for the gun. But I got it first. Started looking at you with that funny look in his eyes. I mean, kill you!
Did you really think he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes, sir.
So it was his life or yours.
And not just mine. So I closed my eyes and I shot.
In defense of your life?
To save my husband's unborn child! Baby?
Roxie, there ain't no baby. But Roxie, I still love you.
They didn't even want my picture. Can you believe that? They didn't even want my picture.
My exit music, please.
Thank you.
You know, a lot of people have lost faith in America.
And what America stands for.
We are the living examples of what a wonderful country this is.
Thank you.